think we should all be mermaids, Karen,
yeah.
You know.
Yeah, but then let's talk about, let's move forward. Did the government do the right thing in going to the UN? Wasn't that the moral high ground of all of this?
The UN is like, I mean, the UN is a political body. China is a member, a permanent member of the Security Council. And you can be sure, I have worked in the UN as a senior official.
Yeah.
The political padlocks are really, they'll squeeze you if you go against the political regime. So I don't think that although we will win our case, China will not will disregard it.
Yeah.
Because she's a permanent member of the Security Council. We are just trying to be a member of the Security Council every 20 years and having such a hard time to be elected.
So what you're saying is you believe we'll win the case?
Well, even if we win the case, it will be an empty victory because China will not abide by international law. What China wants is that we talk to each other, bilateral relation, eyeball to eyeball.
Should we do that?
We should do both.
That
is what I'm trying to say. Our diplomacy is very unidimensional. We should do a lot of back channeling. This is the most creative part of our diplomacy. Mm. Why don't the businessmen doing business in our two countries do something? The women should do something. The intellectuals should do something. The doctors should do something.
I want to ask you.
The media should do something.
Was the Aquino administration wrong in seeming to be confrontational with China? Because clearly bilateral talks was off the question before. That's what led us to it loss.
No, well, I am glad that the UN Convention on the Law of the Sea is there as a kind of a safe harbor for us because we are an archipelago. We are a sea country. We will have a future as a maritime power, not as a land power. So I am glad that we did that. But in addition to that, we should not put our eggs in one basket. That's what I'm trying to say, Karim. Diplomacy can be creative, and you don't have to do it through formal channels all the time, not always through a protocol.
Yeah.
Break the protocol once in a while.
So was Senator Antonio Trillanes right when he claims he was back-channeling with China? You remember?
Yes, that's true. But you see, even back-channeling is an art. It should not be revealed even in the Senate.
Okay. You see? All right, go
on. I mean,
on.
I don't want to offend anyone, but back-channeling has to be secret, but secret among friends, if you know what I mean.
Yeah. Okay. Now, let's talk about after. We win the victory. You said it's an empty victory because China would not adhere, and nobody sees them moving out. Do we need the United States?
Yes, we do, and that is part of our independent foreign policy. Having an independent foreign policy does not mean we have to be anti-American. And this is where I part ways with the left. Because if you, foreign policy basta anti-American, no, we need the American Navy, we need the technology.
So you are for that? Because, you know, there's a different school of thought. Some people say, like Professor Banlawi said, if the U.S. starts having presence in the West Philippine Sea for the Philippines or its own interest, it complicates our relationship.
No, but it means we should have also our channels with China. You see, in other words, our embassy in China is a vital issue. Now, we have our ambassador there. I know she's very hardworking, Ambassador Basilio.
Yeah.
You see, but we also need somebody. She has had to have her own Chinese-speaking staff.
Does she really
speak Mandarin, not always an interpreter, in order to know what is the Chinese mind, you see. And, you know, you must know the price of chickens, eggs, what the common people are thinking of. No, that is what a diplomat should do. It should not always be at this very high level.
Okay.
That is what maybe I am trying to say, that it must also be a people's issue. A local government issue. Let the governors, I know that it is complicated.
Yeah.
And I would like to say, you know, this Ambassador Luceriano, our envoy to Pakistan, who was killed in the helicopter crash, is an example of the diplomat who really sacrifices his life for the country.
Okay.
And I would like to pay tribute to these unknown diplomats who really serve the country just by talking.
Okay, I'm going to ask you, what about ASEAN? I mean, ASEAN, the ASEAN community is, if put together, is a market of 600 million. And yet, in the last World Economic Forum, when I asked the Malaysian trade minister, Malaysia is now chairing ASEAN, and I asked, shouldn't ASEAN have one voice when it comes to the West Philippine Sea issue or the Clayman Island issues? And they said, ideally, yes, but all countries trade with China the most.
Yes.
And doesn't, of course, this weaken also our position?
That is true. ASEAN, the sacred mantra in ASEAN is non-interference in domestic issues.
I see.
See. But so I think to put all of our eggs again in one basket, that is the ASEAN basket, is a no-win. Because Cambodia, which is so close to China, will never do it. Laos, Myanmar, all of these neighboring countries, you see. It's only Vietnam, whom I admire. They imagine they took out that Chinese oil rig, and they're also reclaiming islands now. Yeah. How I wish we could be like the Vietnamese.
But I want to ask you, for Vietnam being such a small country, to take out the oil rig, how did they do that?
Well, you know, they defeated the Americans, don't forget, in the Vietnamese War.
Okay. But I mean, how did they do that today without China reacting violently?
Because they are very nationalistic. They love their country above anything else, and they'll do anything to defend the motherland. Oh. But they also did it in a way that was also diplomatic. It was nearly a shooting war. You know, they had the war with China. Are we ready for that? We're saying, wala tayong kaya eh. You see, we already decide the issue. Wala tayong kaya, wala tayong laban. How do we know? Suppose we ask, we have that Banca Brigade, as Commodore Plaridel Garcia told me. Just for a media thing, then let's get our women. Also the wives of the fisher folk who have to dry fish on the...
But do you really believe in today's time that that is still the solution? I want to ask you, what about the AFP modernization in the 1990s?
That is also one thing. We don't give enough money for our modernization plan. Mm-mm. So many of our budget goes to all of the pockets of those who should be leading us. Mm-mm. We should modernize, and we should be like Vietnam. If Vietnam can afford it, why cannot the Philippines? That's what I'm sort of trying to say. And in ASEAN, some of the ASEAN countries who are poorer than us spend more money, more budget,
on military
or modernization.
So, but should we?
Well, we should. And the
I mean, given that, you know, I mean, I just wanted to ask you, given that the description of the Philippines in the world is, we are soft power. Our people speak English. Our people relatively can work anywhere abroad. They say that we should put more money in education.
Well, what's wrong with hard power, Karen, if we are threatened? We are threatened, so we just want to be soft? No. I mean, the patriot in me says you've got to fight where you can fight. Just like our heroes. I mean, Andres Bonifacio fought the Spaniards with his bolo.
Actually, now I'm getting your train of thought. If we were serious about beefing up the military, and really training them, and it's not just words, so to speak. What you're saying is, if China sees, even though how small, that the Philippines is serious in defending its territories, do you see our ally countries coming to our aid?
Of course.
I see.
You see,
that's
because
the point.
They're asking, why should we risk ourselves for the Philippines? Are they willing to risk themselves for themselves?
That's the point.
That's what other countries are waiting for.
Yeah.
And if we will keep saying, oh, America, please come and save us.
Without us doing anything.
Yeah. America, you know, the voters now will ask Hillary Clinton, hey, Hillary, are you going to save the Philippines if they don't do anything to help themselves? And you know what Hillary will say? She's a smart politician.
She would say,
I will put my money where the pocket is. Our allies will have to learn how to help themselves.
So that's the interesting part, is really our allies may help us more if they see us helping ourselves first.
Yeah, why should they spend money for somebody who will be forever be dependent on them? That is life. Yeah. And this is what an independent foreign policy means. It does not mean you're against the world. No, you show that you can be a dependable friend.
Okay.
Now, what can we give to America if he's here? Well, we can keep their soldiers safe from harm, etc., and let our courts also be fair and so on.
Okay. All right. We're going to go to a quick break. We'll be right back.